Yeah, go ahead. I'm going to tweet this right now.
We're just going to keep bitching about E3.
Yeah, this year is going to be, I'm telling you right now, it's going to be, like, if you're going to go, it's going to be clogged up even more with just the people that have passes who are just going to be there just to play games and not to report on anything and want to do work.
See, I think that the way to do that is to still have the 3 days, but to leave it, you should have a fourth day or maybe even a fifth day that's open to the public.
Exactly. You know, but then you have to rent out another day of space. You have to, the developers have to be there to still, you know, talk about the game. You know, adding an additional day is a big deal.
Yeah, I get it.
But anyway, this is Squall Snake from MyGamer.com, and we are playing Hitman.
We are indeed.
And I have very limited experience with the Hitman.
With the Hitman.
With the Hitman. Are we on? It says that we're offline.
Yeah, it's saying that we are streaming.
Oh, there it goes. It just takes forever. All right, never mind. We're good.
There it is. Yep. Yeah. I was just checking that.
Yeah. Yeah, I haven't I know the Hitman series has been around forever. There's been a ton of games. I never really just had the chance to play it. It was a free, it was like, oh man, Hitman something on 360 was like a free Xbox games for gold game 1 month, like a couple years ago. And I played it for like 10 minutes, like the first level, and I died because I didn't know what was going on because I didn't put the right costume on at the right time or something.
Oh yeah, there's like all this stuff that like, basically, a lot of Hitman is sort of exploring the level and seeing what you can do and seeing where stuff is.
Is it trial and error? Like, if you fuck up, like, you kind of have to start the whole thing over again?
Absolutely.
I think I like the idea of Hitman, but I don't know if it's, like, too tedious or something, but that's just my ignorance talking, but... which is why I wanted to stream this. You know, you said that you had it, and I haven't checked it out, and I want to check it out again. Like I said, I haven't had a good opportunity to play it, to watch it, but I've just obviously heard a lot about it.
Yeah. So it's interesting in that there's like 1,000 fucking ways to do your objective.
That's what I heard. Like, it's not just do one, like, you can attack it from many different angles, which is cool.
Well, the thing that's, and, like, you can go up to, like, almost anyone and just be like, I'm gonna subdue this guy. And it's, like, nine times out, like, one time that's a good fucking idea. Like one time out of 1,000, that's a good idea. Like, I can subdue that guy. But the problem is, I'm in a huge crowd. Like, everyone's gonna fucking notice.
Yeah.
Well,
that's the point, is to be stealthy about it and... Oh, found trespassing,
yeah,
watch
yeah,
out,
the
here
thing
we
is,
go.
Like, so, like, people were just like, hey, you need to get the fuck out of here. And, like, so they'll say something and...
Excuse me, mister. This place is off limits.
Yeah.
So... What's the objective right now? Is there
I have 2 targets that I'm supposed to kill.
And now if you hit start or something, does it say what you have to do or like where you need to go? Or is there like a map? Is there a waypoint?
View intel. So there is, like, different things, and there's timing, so, like, the targets will go about their business. So they will just walk around and, like, do whatever it is that they are going to be doing. Wish I had
that job. Okay. Yeah, it's kind of like, like Metal Gear Ground Zeroes, where it's like targets move and you have to keep up with it. If you take too long, then they're going to be in a different spot and it's going to be harder.
Yeah, exactly. Except this is like, it's sort of stuff is planned out, like where they're going to be.
Yeah.
And like, so I can disguise myself as this guy.
You just killed that guy?
Yeah.
Non-target killed. There we go. Okay.
You got a problem with me fucking just...
No, I didn't know if you just like knocked him out or something or what. Because then if he gets knocked out, does he come back to life?
Well, yeah, he would like wake up and that's why I murdered him.
Yeah. It's his fault for trying to wake up.
Yeah, I mean...
That's what you get, now you get murdered.
Yeah. So, fuck you. For not knowing that you should never attempt to wake up. So yeah, disguise myself as an employee and kind of...
Is that a target right there on your map? Is that the white circle? Is that...
Yeah. But the thing is, like, you can see how many fucking guards there are.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's a lot of money. Look, we could argue about this later. I've got to show you one. Oh, so you could have dropped that on him, huh?
Yeah.
Well, now you know for next time.
Yeah, exactly. And that's kind of a lot of what this is. Jesus,
where are my pinky duckles? Sir, you should go back. You really don't want any trouble here.
Oh, she's coming
that's
after
good,
you.
Sir. Keep going.
Sir, I'm fucking one of the employees, you cocks. I can just walk through here.
Yeah.
Fuck it.
Oh! Wrong person.
Don't care.
It's just, yeah, wrong per... Oh, wow, he's got a gun.
Yeah, oh, and you die super fast, too.
I was gonna say, that's gonna be 1, 2, 3... Well, now we know to we can drop the chandelier on him. Maybe we go that route and just get the hell out of there.
Yeah. Well, and there's also a second person that you need to fucking take out too.
Why are we taking out this guy? Did we know? Do we know this?
He's an asshole. Not...
Reason that hey, that works for me.
We were paid to. We're a hitman.
Oh, money talks.
And I kill.
And business is good.
That was really dumb.
So have you played all the Hitmans?
I own, like, way more of them than I would ever like to admit to.
Because they HD-ified the Hitman trilogy, no? That was on 360?
That... sounds about right.
Yeah. But this is the latest one, right? Minus Hitman Go?
Yeah, this actually came out after Hitman Go, so yeah.
Oh, okay, alright.
Welcome, sir. Enjoy the show. And I think, yeah, so... This is the target coming down the stairs right now.
Ah. There's a ton of people in this mansion here.
Oh, yeah.
What does that say?
Blend in as palace staff.
Oh. Oh, he's coming for you. Hit him over the head with that ship.
Stop the strangling right now.
Hunted. Oh, there he goes.
That's one of my favorite lines that I've heard in a while. Stop the strangling right now.
Because you can't say the code word.
No.
You don't know what their code word is.
They don't know the safe word.
Yes, the safe word. Thank you.
Stop the strangling right now. Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
I was gonna do it in 4 minutes.
Yeah. I was just gonna hold him down until like all motion stop, but right now. Okay.
So, being that it is at the time of this recording, it is Wednesday, March 1st, 2017, and in 2 days,
no.
The Nintendo Switch is going to launch.
The answer is no.
I am also getting a no. Yeah, I mean, there's really not a, you know, other than Zelda, there's no reason to get a Switch at launch.
No, there's not. There's no reason to get a Switch, like, as far as I can tell, within the first year.
Yeah, I mean, they were saying Mario Odyssey is going to be holiday.
Maybe.
This year, you know, so I'm assuming that's, you know, November.
Yeah.
But. You know, I think it's still way too early. They want to get it out before holiday, I'm sure. But yeah, I mean, other than Zelda, which I'm going to get on Wii U because I'm still excited to play it. The only other Switch game like that's within the quote unquote launch window is Puyo Puyo Tetris, which is
coming out on the PS4.
But it's also on PS4, so it's not even a console exclusive. I mean, there's going to be good reasons to get the Switch, you know, console exclusive titles in time, but right now, and plus the only way to get one is if you were lucky enough to pre-order, or if you go camp in line. GameStop has been saying that they are going to get a few. I was at a GameStop today, and they're saying they're going to get a few extras, but you're going to have to wait in line. And they said that, you know, the people are going to be, you know, because they're doing a true midnight launch, and, you know, people are going to start waiting in line, you know, hours before the store opens. And if they only have 5 extra consoles, they're just going to tell the first 5 people, hey, you guys are getting them. Everybody else is not. So don't even waste your time. I got some friends who work at Target, and he said that they're going to get about 15. His store is going to get about 15 Switches and a bunch of accessories. And they got, you know, all the Zelda Amiibos and everything, too.
Yeah.
So it's not like a tremendous, you know, each store is not getting hundreds of consoles, so people will be lining up. You know, 15 is not a lot, and this is one of the, you know, it is a bigger Target store. It's not like a, you know, a smaller Target store, so you can only imagine, you know, other stores are going to get significantly less numbers than that. So I'm not dealing with that. That's, you know, there's no point in getting one now.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I remember the Wii U was fucking difficult to get for no reason.
Well, yeah, I mean, look at Nintendo. So, like, the Wii, the original Wii, which launched in 2006, was you could not find a Wii for, like, a fucking year after it launched. The Nintendo Classic Edition, the $60 thing this holiday, you still can't find any. The Amiibo craze was nuts. You know, they were only making, like, 4 Amiibo, like, you know, total. So, you know, even the GameCube adapter for the Wii U to play Smash Brothers on Wii U was, you know, they only made like 6 of them. You know, so this is, you know, Nintendo.
I own one of them. They're like actually kind of easy to get now.
Now they're fine. Now it's not a big deal. But at the time, they did not, you know, they only made like, again, 6, right? And now, you know, you could get them all over the place. That's not, but they did, because they restocked them, like, was it 8 to 10 months after, you know, the demand was there? So, who knows? I mean, there's no point in getting one now anyway, so I'm not going to go crazy and stress myself trying to hunt one of these things down and buying one on eBay for double the price. Screw that. It's, you know, well, I'll get one. So I'm hoping that, and I wrote an article, a blog post on the site about it. I was like, hopefully by the time I'm ready to get one, which is probably going to be holiday, it'll be bundled with the game, or you know, there'll be a discount, or like, you know, an extra controller, something that's extra. I doubt there'll be like this slim version of the Switch by then, you know, maybe give that a couple few years, but
yeah, because you know, there's a slim version of the fucking Wii U, right?
Right. Well, there's a slim version of everything else, you know, but or a, instead of a slim version, a pro version, you know, where it's going to have extra memory inside or something like that. That's the other thing. It's only got 32 gigs. And then they're saying after formatting, you're looking at like 25 or something, you know, of internal storage space. You're going to have to get a memory card, you know, an SD card of some kind. But so there's all these things that, you know, could get better in the future. So early adopters always get screwed anyway. Plus, they were saying, like, early reports are saying that the Joy-Con controllers are not syncing right. Did you see that?
Supposedly, it's already been fixed.
I don't know if there's a patch, but there's a day one patch on the system, you know, firmware update.
Yeah.
Hide. If you hide, will they just go away?
Let's find out. Yep, target's gone.
Oh, we got some movement on the radar, and there's a guy right there, obviously. But
apparently they're not that smart.
Did you see the Hitman movie?
I did not, no.
Neither did I. I got bad reviews. These guys are still hunting you down.
Yeah, I know.
Oh. I like how you can just change your pants in like a second. Like you don't even have to take your shoes off. They just like warp onto your body. Oh. It was a huge kitchen. Combat? You're just not supposed to be in here?
Yo, no, not at all.
Oh. They're hunting you down. This game is hard.
Yeah, it did not go the way I wanted it.
Wow, yeah.
I kind of, like, gave up.
This kind of, like, distracts me from playing Hitman because it seems like the difficulty is rather high. I guess there could be a good moment of satisfaction when you're done if you actually, like,
well,
pull it
like,
off.
You know, like, once you know the level, you can be like, I'm going to put, like, you can... Excuse me, you can put, like, remote explosives in,
Yeah. you could plan ahead if you know what's going
on. Well, and there's like, I know there's like a camera that you can find that like you can plant remote explosives in.
Do you have to pick up all your equipment in the level, or can you go?
I think there are like drops you can do. Like her, there's a lens that you can pick up, but if I find a remote detonator, I can literally put a remote detonator in that camera, so when she's filming an interview with the guy...
It just blows up.
It murders him.
Mm-hmm.
And he stops to get a drink at one point. And if I can poison that, but I have to like find this shit. I have no idea where.
So you can get pretty creative with the murdering.
Yeah. It's a bathroom. I can go into a bathroom.
Oh, this is a chick bathroom. Is this the first stage in the game?
It's one of them. Maybe I didn't have to kill that guy.
Better to be safe than be sorry.
Well, no, there's a disguise, like, sitting right there. That I could have taken.
What are you going to do with those skizzers?
Whatever I want.
Well, here you go. Blow some shit up.
I'm missing her wrench. Ooh, rat poison.
There you go. Put that in the drink.
Yep. Now the question is, like, did I miss this, like, the timing on this entirely?
I was gonna say maybe he's already past the bar stage.
Yeah. Oh well, then I'll just poison some unsuspecting asshole.
You pour it in your own drink and roofie yourself.
Yeah, go for it. Yeah, I think he's past here. Fuck.
Well, you can't let good rat poison go to waste.
Yeah.
I don't like the looks of you. Sorry, but he's being a real dick.
Running around like overflowing sinks left and right.
You like to waste your water.
Yep.
Show them who's boss. You do what you want.
I do what I want.
You didn't get Final Fantasy 15, did you?
No, it's still too expensive.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking myself.
It's still too expensive. They want money for it.
Because Hitman is Square Enix.
Yeah, it is Squeenix.
Yeah. Are you going to get Zelda on Wii U?
I might. At the moment, I'm, like, not spending any money.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I already got my pre-order in at GS.
Oh, boy. Aren't they lucky?
Yeah. You know what's going to be? I'm not even dealing with the midnight deal. Screw that. I'm going to go on my own time on Friday when there's no line and no chaos.
Yeah, make sure that they don't sell your copy.
Nah, I don't think the demand for the Wii U version is going to be...
You never know.
Actually, I thought
it's fucking GameStop, so they
I thought I thought I read a story where... I don't know if it was GameStop or Amazon stopped taking pre-orders for Zelda. I got just like the not the limited, just like the regular edition of the game.
Really?
I don't know. Yeah, maybe it was. I think I want to say it was GameStop, but maybe it was. I just remember seeing a news headline. And again, I don't know if that's the Wii U version, the Switch version, both. Was there ever a co-op Hitman? I don't think so, right?
Not to my knowledge.
That's like, I think, where they're going to have to take the franchise next.
Yeah, I severely doubt they're going to do that.
Go the Assassin's Creed route. Like, well, we made 9,000 single-player games. Let's just make a co-op, and it'll be really buggy and bad.
Buggy and bad?
I never played it, but that was the consensus was it was buggy, it was bad. It was Unity.
Yeah, yes.
But do you even really want to play Assassin's Creed at this point anyway?
Well, no, but do you?
No.
Serious, sir, you're not authorized to be here.
That's the way.
Killed guys for less.
Stay in the stage area, please.
Screwdriver. Oh.
He did just kind of call me a shitbag, so I don't feel bad about it.
Yeah, he deserved it.
And now I'm just kind of...
like, how many people can I kill without being noticed and just go on a murderous rampage?
The answer was none, by the way.
It's a sharp looking screwdriver. Could do some damage with that.
Ignore me! Ignore me! This is super interesting, what's going on up here, but...
That's just chaos.
Yeah. It's been about half an hour. I think that's good.
Yeah, this has been a good... See, this is what scares me about Hitman. It's like, I don't know... Like, you're going to fail a lot, I think, and I don't know if I have the patience to keep to play it 10 times until I get it right.
See, especially, I bought this, you know, as something to show off my new graphics card, and for that, I think it works. So tell them where they can find you, sir.
So you could follow me, of course, on MyGamer.com. You could follow me on Twitter at Zack Gaz, ZackGaz. And you, sir, are?
I'm Gillman. You can follow me on MyGamer, where I'm Gillman, and I post things. And
yeah, we post everything there. Just posted a bunch of news, reviews.
And YouTube,
go check it out. Streams, we'll post this stream up. You're probably going to be watching this stream there anyway. And we'll be back next week, Wednesday, with another game, maybe Zelda, who knows. But until next time, game on.